يا نفس إن لم تظفري لا تجزعي.
You remember, I gave a talk here and I mentioned about Jesus. That Jesus is mentioned in this volume 500% more times than Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Something unimaginable. You can't imagine. A man goes and writes a book and he keeps himself out of it. He's promoting Jesus. Jesus 500% more time than himself. Does it make sense? Which writer? Which biographer? No. This is not his work. If it was his work, then naturally he would have promoted himself. He's mentioned in the Quran 5 times total. 4 times as Muhammad and 1 time as Ahmad, which is an alternative way of naming of the Prophet. Altogether 5. Jesus 25. Amazing. When I tell you this, another mighty messenger of God, Hazrat Musa alayhi salam, we call him Moses, the Holy Prophet Moses. I can't imagine anybody guessing. How many times is he mentioned in this book? The Prophet of the Jews. No, he's our Prophet. How many times is Moses mentioned in this book? Anybody can tell me, or anywhere near enough, Moses. How many times is Moses mentioned in this book? 136 times the Holy Prophet Moses is mentioned in this book. And you people are thinking that we are the Antichrist, we are the anti-Jews. This book is not anti-Jews nor anti-Christian. Look up the birth of Jesus and memorize the verse. Memorize the verse, the ayah in Arabic. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Wa iz qalatil malaikatu ya Maryam, with the meaning. It says, behold, the angel said, O Mary, inna Allah astafaki, Allah has chosen thee, wa taharaki, and purified thee, wa astafaki ala nisa'il alameen, chosen thee above the women of all nations. Mary, the mother of Jesus, is described in the Quran as a woman chosen above the women of all nations. And I'm saying that this honor, this high honor, is not to be found given to Mary, the mother of Jesus, even in the Christian Bible, whether the Protestant version or the Roman Catholic version. I have them both. Nowhere you find anything like this. So the story is that in these verses, the mother of Mary, she was barren for a long period of time. And she prayed to God. So, oh my Lord, if you give me a child, I'll devote my child for temple services, for your service. I'll dedicate her. And God heard her prayer and she became pregnant from her husband. And in time she delivered the child. And the child happened to be a female. And she was disappointed. She had vowed that that child she will dedicate, imagining, thinking it will be a son, a male. But it happened to be a female. What is she to do? She had vowed. So she buys her time when Mary was big enough that she can look after herself. She takes this child to the temple for handing over. And the priest in the temple of Jerusalem, they're seeing this beautiful child. Everybody wants to be a godfather. You know godfather? That's how the Westerners say, you know. Everyone says, look, I'll look after the child. The other one says, I'll be the godfather. I'll look after the child. And there's competition. So they started casting lots. Head or tail. And it came to the turn of Zechariah. Zechariah won the toss. The father of John the Baptist, he won the toss. But in things like this, there's always a dispute. You say, you didn't play fair. You know, you didn't throw the dice nicely. You know, so there was a dispute. So the Quran tells us that, O Muhammad, you were not there when they cast lots with arrows as to which of them should be charged with the care of Mary, nor was thou with them when they disputed the point. How do you know these things? How does Muhammad know? He's an illiterate man, a man who doesn't know how to read or write. How does he know this? So Allah gives the answer. كَذَلِكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الْغَيْبِ نُوحِيهِ إِلَيْكَ. This is part of the tidings of the things unseen, which we reveal unto thee, O Messenger, by inspiration. This is how he got this knowledge. Whatever is given to him, he's got no choice, he's got to utter them. That Mary, a Jewess, the mother of Jesus, she is a woman chosen above the women of all nations. It doesn't make sense. Not his own mother, Muhammad's mother, not even his mother, not his wife, not his daughter. When we believe that his daughter Fatima will be the leader of the women of paradise. But no, even her name is not mentioned in this book. Her name is not mentioned. Muhammad's mother's name is not mentioned. Not a single of his wife's names are mentioned. Amazing, this book. So people get puzzled. You see, when they get a book like this, you present them, they are looking for Muhammad, his family history. And you don't find it. You wonder who is his father. You know his father's name is not there. You don't know where he was born. It's not here. Do you know that? Who was his father? Who's his mother? Where he was born? Where he died? Nothing. Nothing at all. Why? Jesus, his annunciation, the good news, is described in two places in the Quran. Two places. Muhammad's birth is not mentioned at all. Muhammad is mentioned 5 times. Jesus 25 times. Moses 136 times. No. This is a very amazing book. So now, we Muslims are made to believe that Jesus is one of the mightiest messengers of God. That he is the Messiah, the Messiah, translated Christ. Messiah in Arabic, Messiah in Hebrew, translated into Greek, Christos. We Muslims believe that Jesus was the Christ. We have no other Christ. Have we? Have we Muslims got another Christ? No. Do I love